What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today we're going to review Ribbet Photo Editor. And yes, that is Ribbet like when frogs sing. So what I'm going to do in this video is that I'm actually going to edit one of my photos to show you how the photo editor works. Now, heads up, this is different from a design editor. So if you have previous deals like Crello, Stencil, well, the focus area of those kind of deals is different from this one. What I mean by that? Well, let's just say that the design editor is meant for example, you can add elements, you can add squares, triangles, text, and there's templates available that you can use to add your products and all of that. In this case, no, this is a photo editor. And where it actually shines is when you are editing people. Why? Because for example, with this editor, you can actually remove pimples, you can remove scars, you can add blemish, you can add lipstick, you can add, change the eye color. And it's different tools that what you have from a design editor. So enough talk about that. Let's check out what the lifetime deal is about and how Ribbet Photo Editor actually works and stands out. So let's go jump over to the deal right now. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now, and it starts off at $49 for the lifetime deal if you are a plus member or a briefcase member of Appsumo. If you're not, I will leave the details in the description so you can check out if it's beneficial for you to jump into the plus membership or the briefcase membership. But if not, the deal is $69 normally, right? You don't need any membership to grab this lifetime deal. And if you guys want to grab it, that link will be in the description for both of the deals. Now, like I mentioned before, it's a photo editor, not an image, well, a design editor, okay? And what you get with the deal is that you get the pro version, so there's no limitations to that, and you get access to 2.7 million free stock photos that you can use. Now, like I mentioned before, there's several tools that design editors don't have, but this one does. So let's actually jump into my dashboard. And let me upload a new image because I already played with that one. Let me upload, here it is. Let me grab this screenshot that I'm going to use from my previous thumbnail for a video, and I'm gonna show you what it's capable of. Okay, let's wait for that to upload, and there we go, it's loading. Okay, so here's the image, all right? And we have the tools on the left. The first tools that you get are like the general use tools. So for example, we can use auto fix, and let's just click on it. And what it just did is like it raised the contrast so you can see everything darkened up a little bit. The colors popped a little bit more so that raised the saturation. But this is just like the auto fix. If you wanna use something simple and fast, well, that could work out. Let's go back, that's the original one. I'm not gonna show you how crop works, pretty simple, straightforward, rotate also. The exposure, we can expose, see what happens. We can highlight and we can darken shadows. So this one's pretty useful. For example, for this, in my case, for example, I would actually use some shadow. There's also contrast, see how that works. If you go too far, it's obvious that it's gonna look bad, right? Then we can use auto exposure if we want. Colors, we can raise the saturation, which is gonna raise all the colors. We can change the temperature, all right? So if it's too bluish, like cold, well, we can add some temperature to it. We can sharpen, so for example, you'll see, I'll go extreme for everything so you see what happens, okay? So if I go sharpen this, you can actually see that on my beard, that you can see it's more crisp because it sharpened it. But sometimes you don't wanna go too far because, for example, you'll see some signs of wrinkles. For example, if you go too far, it looks too much, or for clarity, see what it does. So if you go too far, it's gonna look bad. But if you do this subtly, it'll look really good. We can also resize, and there's the canvas color. So for example, if I need to know what this color of my skin is, well, here it is, all right? Click on it, there we go. And now I know what the color is and the hash is, all right? Text, we can add some text to this. For this case, like I mentioned before, the whole purpose of this tool is not focused on design editor. So you don't see a lot of type of templates available to add here. So for example, here's the text, I can move it around. We have the fonts that are available right here. So there's quite a lot of fonts available here. There's normal, regular, bold, and italic, the size, the color, the stroke, drop shadow, for example, for that, gradient. Let me see if we have other options there. We can change the shadow there. Again, for gradient, we can do that there. Show the grain, curved text. Okay, that curved too much, but we can reduce and spacing. It could be used for something else. and this I wouldn't use it, all right? Light spacing, line height, so alignment, transform, flip, and decoration. There's no templates for text that are pretty useful, because maybe you want something that's pretty cool that's already happening, and it's like rounded text, curved, and that's not available on this deal. If I want to get rid of it, click delete. Effects, okay? I'm not a fan of effects. Some people are, but for example, there's black and white, which is pretty simple. Matte, vignette, Morocco, Cairo, and all of that. Like I said, I'm not a fan of that. Let's go back to original. Overlays, again, there's just things that go on top of it. Sometimes they look good, sometimes they don't. You have several options for the overlays for each one that you select. You can add how much is going to look, just a bit or a lot. The blend mode, how is it going to blend? Add, defer, highlight. It's just gonna, you can add the type of blend, if it's gonna blend with you, what's on the photo or not, or if it's gonna be on top, and that kind of way. Let's go back to original. The touch up. This is my favorite part about Ribbet, okay? This is what I think that makes it shine. Obviously, these tools are super more complex and better on Photoshop, but you know Photoshop's expensive, it's not a lifetime deal, and for obvious reasons, Photoshop is like king, all right? So this is what we're able to do with this one. So for example, we can remove shine. So for example, if I want to remove a little bit shine of here and here, and we can change the brush size, and we can erase. So the brush size is if we want to do more. Now, I didn't see a lot of effects on this one. So let's go sunless. So if we want to do a suntan, let's erase the brush there, and we can add a bit of suntan there. So now I'm more brown than what I am before. Now I'm just doing this really crazy, but obviously you would do this with like calmer, right? So you wouldn't get, you don't grab the eye, you don't grab the beard. You can do the brush size, the color strength. So if you don't want to go too far because it looks too harsh, well, just a little bit, right? There, you do some touch up. You can darken also, and the brush size is there. Let's remove that. Okay, the blush, let's raise the brush size, and let's use something more pinkish. There's some blush there. Now you see the pink is really hard, but when we fade in, it looks subtle, and you can, it's usable. If you go all the way like that, it's like, hey, you know that's fake. But if you use the fade, it looks subtle and it works out. Okay, let's remove that. Okay, the wrinkle remover. So for example, I'll use my forehead to remove that. See how that cleaned it up? Now, wrinkle is pretty harsh, so I would use a little bit more of fade. I wouldn't go too far, like around there. Okay, so you can see that. I'll fix this there. And I'll remove that some there and a little bit there. And now I'm like 5 years younger than I look normally by using the wrinkle remover. Let's go back and get rid of that. Oops, one more to the front. There we go. The airbrush, again, we can brush this right there. Let's go, let's remove the fade. There we go, you kind of see the brush there. I still see some, there we go, now we're normal. The airbrush, let me use this, and let's brush something here. So it kind of blurs in the effect. Not much going on there. Again, I went too far, my bad. All right, the blemish remover. So this one is pretty useful to remove, for example, pimples, scars, wrinkles. So right here, okay? Let me zoom in right here to my face. All right, so we got a big pimple right here. I'm gonna click on it. And it's gone, all right? I got another one over here, it's gone. It's right there, there, and a little bit there. We can clean up all these little pimples and imperfections, and basically they're gone, all right? So it's simple, blemish fix. So we can use a skin fixer, so the wrinkle remover and the blemish, and you're gonna have really good results. In my opinion, I would use the blemish first and then use the wrinkle remover, okay? And let's unzoom that there. There's the eyeliner. Whoa, let's go back. Touch up. Okay, there's the eyeliner. If you want to do that there, I'll just go really dark there. You see what the results are. Let's remove that. There's the eye color. So for example, if I want to go green, let me zoom in. Let me zoom in a bit more. Lower the brush size a little bit smaller. Okay, that looks like I'm a vampire or something like that. But if we use some fade, it's gonna look a little bit more realistic. All right, let's fade right about there. Let's zoom out. Okay, there you go. See how that looks? Now I got green eyes. Eye bright, if I wanna brighten it up, mascara, eye pencil, eye shadow. Obviously, all these tools are meant for women or men who wanna make up, okay? Teeth whitening, all right, so let's whiten out the teeth. Yeah, now I got some really white teeth. Again, you gotta do this with subtle and do it with calm, not like I'm doing it right now in this demo. And the lip color, if I wanna do some red, oh, that's actually pinkish. Again, I'm just playing around right here. There we go. And then the highlights, this is for, well, my non-existing hair, but you can see what happens, all right? What it's gonna do, it's gonna highlight by doing that, by like raising the color there. Thin, I think this doesn't work out pretty well because what it does is just, it stretches and it tightens the image. And that's how it creates the effect of thin. So it's gonna make the image like this to make you look a little bit thinner. So not a whole lot of things to do there, okay? Next thing we have is the layouts. So layouts, if you wanna use and create several images in one, like a collage, you can do that there. There's a grid option, there's big photo option, there's jigsaw, and you can add images to these. I won't do it right now because it's gonna create a whole mess and I'll have to add a whole bunch of images, but it's pretty much basic. What it looks like right there, you add images to it. There's the pro options for pro adjustment. So you have exposure, highlights, shadows, contrast, and all these. Apply effects. There's paint options there. There's the library from all the photos that's uploaded. Here's my previous one that I was working with and the one that I'm working right now. And there's the stock photo images that they have on deal, which they say it's 2.7 million photos that you can use without having any problems, right? So if I add this, hello. Okay, there we go. Using design, download, or save to photos. I can save it to photos, and they are from Unsplash. So that's where they grab this library, all right? But basically, that is Ribbet Photo Editor, all right? So like I mentioned before, it's different from a design editor. A design editor would have templates that you can use, for example, for products, for services, most intended for businesses. And this one is more for photo editing. So you can change the highlights, exposures, contrast, fix the skin on the subject and all of that. So that's pretty cool that Ribbet has. Now, that said, things that I don't like about Ribbet is that I wish these, for example, let's go into the touch-ups. Some of these I wish they were a little bit more subtle so they work out. And some of them that I've used, for example, airbrush, they don't have a lot of, you don't see a lot of changes there. So they either need to fix it, make it better, or get rid of it, all right? So basically that's it. If you have photos that you want to edit really quickly and you are not using Photoshop or you don't want to go through the hassle of opening Photoshop because it's really hardware intense, or maybe you are traveling and you want to edit a photo and you are at a friend's computer or a paid per hour computer, something like that. Well, you just open up the browser, open up Ribbet Editor and edit the photos without having to download any software. So that's pretty things that I think are interesting with Ribbet. Well, there you go, guys. If you find these features helpful and if you like Ribbet, well, like I mentioned before in the beginning, there is a link in the description that helps me out with a small commission that if you buy through that link, it helps me out and I keep making these videos for you guys. Well, I thank you all for watching. My name is George. This is Askmaster and I'll see you guys later.